Knock knock.
Who's there?
A joke.
A joke who?
A joke that makes you laugh. I don't know any joke. It's working on me.
That worked on me, obviously. Silly John. We're here in the office just working. Getting work done.
Yeah, no joke. Work. Don't be angry. Oh, okay. So when you are angry, just think about it. Why are you angry? And then you think, why you shouldn't be angry. That should give you the answer.
The question is, should we allow same-sex marriage? Should we? The thing is, here in Australia, we get to vote. And I received my letter of the mail, and the question is, should we allow same-sex marriage? And why should, this is a bit disconcerting, because why is it that we're actually voting for that? There are parts of the world where you actually don't vote and they allow same-sex marriages, or they just allow it. Like, there's no voting that's happening. Australia, we're a little bit behind the time, and this is a very hot topic to talk about. And it's your opinion is your opinion, and I respect that. This is my opinion. If you are in love with somebody, why should I stop you from marrying that person? And I just don't think it's right to vote. I just think that if you want to get married, you just get married. And Australia is behind the time. And yes, there's a lot of conversations about it. It's a hot topic, but I just think you love somebody, get married to them. Put a ring on it. How to deal with anger. How do you deal with anger now? Believe it or not, and I tell this to people, they don't believe that I was a very, very angry person at one point in time of my life. And you know what? I hate to admit it, but I was very angry. A very angry person that I didn't even know who I was, and I'm glad I'm not that person again. Not now. And I don't think I ever want to be in that situation. How do I deal with anger? And I'll give you top 10 tips. One is identify that, you are human. You have the right to be angry. You have the right to be frustrated. You have the right to feel, and you have emotions. But when your anger continues on a period of time that's way too long, you need to identify that, you need to question that, because it's actually unhealthy for the human body. I feel that it isn't, and it's quite stressful, and you're using a lot of energy. So one is identify your anger. Why is it they angry? Okay, and what can I do to fix that? Two, I started to breathe, breathe. Make sure there's oxygen to the brain, and when you breathe slower and holding it in longer, you're actually reducing your heartbeat, okay? And you're having more oxygen, and you're breathing in more, and the oxygen actually goes to your brain. And count to 10 seconds, that actually helps. And then talk, but breathe and then think about the next word before saying it, because words can hurt, just remember that. The other point would be is to just step away from the situation and go, nope, hold on, what's going on here? Why am I getting angry? Why is this happening? What am I getting angry about? Is it worth getting angry about? After you figure out, okay, what are you angry about? What I want you to do is, once you're calm, express your anger, but not in the tone of anger. So express your anger, going, look, I had to walk away from the situation and I'm angry. I now need to discuss how I feel, and let's talk about this. So you say it in a calm voice, because, both of you guys have walked away from the situation and you've come to a point where, okay, your ego is here and your calmness is here. Not up here, because we don't want it up here. Because if you guys are both like angry, like, discussion's not gonna continue, is it? So you have to stop and just speak in a calm voice. My other tip is to do yoga, to exercise, get out, have some air, but exercise, because I've noticed that when I did yoga, it actually had reduced depression, anxiety, but also my anger. And I thank yoga for that, because part of yoga and playing golf, it helps you meditate. So you are actually getting more oxygen in your brain. So going back to my other tip, it's actually getting more oxygen to your brain, and you're thinking more. And it does hugely help, hugely. I said take time out, identify possible solutions. And what I mean by identifying possible solutions is don't resolve the issue at hand, resolve it a little bit later. So that's a little bit overlapping of what I was saying, but it's really identifying possible solutions. So yes, you're angry. Okay, what can I do now to not get myself so angry? But what is the solution for what you guys have argued about? So coming back to, okay, look, I am in a calmer state now. Look, here are some solutions to resolving this problem. If you consider it a problem, you word it in a way that, you know, it doesn't drastically destroy the both of you guys to communicate in a way. Stick with I statements. So don't say you did this, you didn't do this, you know, should have done this. Do it in a way is like I should have looked at this way. How about if we looked at this way, if I can actually do it this way? Do you think that this would work for the both of us, or do you think I should? So don't always, in an argument, blame them. It's their fault. And you know, us humans, we easily blame people, easily do. And we don't even stand up and, you know, because our ego is so big. So if you just step back and go, you know what? I am just going to think this through, and I am going to be taking this sort of an action. Would you agree with this? Or, you know, so just doing something that, you know, you're not pointing the finger at somebody else. So they're seeing, oh, okay, she is thinking, she's been considerate, he or she's been considerate. Another thing is don't hold a grudge. And I didn't know that I actually do this, and I have to admit, I am human. Holding grudges isn't healthy. And if you can actually tackle what your problems are right there and then, well, not there and then, but afterwards when you're calmer, but just have a look and let that out. So with work and with my family, what I actually do now is I do my incompletes. And I tell them, look, there's an opportunity here that we can actually discuss. This is how I feel. And the team will come up with a solution with me, see if we can actually resolve something. And to let that out of your system, it feels good, because if you continue with this grudge, that's gonna bottle things up. And in a relationship, we tend to do that. We tend to not speak it out. We tend to keep it in here, and one day it's going to explode. It will. I believe it will. Use humor to release tension. And I laugh a lot more now with people, and there are moments where, like, you gotta laugh out loud. You gotta joke it out and go, okay, let's just laugh at this for a moment and go, okay, why are we firing each other up? And just be humorous about it, you know? There's so much things to life. So much more things, instead of being stressful and putting all that negative energy, sad energy, anger into that energy, into that. Practice relaxation skills. So meditation is my form of, and this was going back to the yoga conversation, meditation in itself helps release the tension inside you. So you're inhaling positivity and exhaling negativity. That's how I see it. And the last one, I think I've given you maybe more. I'll have to count back of how many tips I've offered you, but that's all right. If I give you more tips, that's fine, right? The more advice you get, the more better. Is to actually seek advice, ask for help. You know, you can't do it alone all the time, and having another third person opinion or fourth person opinion and average it out, see what their thoughts are. Go to somebody who's actually a calm person, like myself, and ask, Phuong, I'm in a situation where I'm pulling my hair out. What is it that I can actually do? And I'm happy to go through and discuss some of that with you guys, but seek help, because not always what we think is right, because we have a certain belief system, we have a certain limiting belief system as well. So, hope that helps you guys.